In today's video, I'm going to talk about duty of care in relation with omissions and third parties. English law draws a strong line between acts and omissions. Only the former generally attract liability. There is no liability for omitting to act. Donal Nolan defines an omission as defendant failing to confer a benefit on claimant. A person is not liable for a pure omission which is unrelated to a course of conduct. For example, if you see someone fall into a river and drown, you are not liable in negligence for omitting to save them. Lord Goff in Smith v. Littlewoods set out the exceptional circumstances in which duty of care for omissions could exist. Number 1. Where there is a relationship between the parties which creates an assumption of responsibility on behalf of the defendant with safety of the claimant. In Barrett v. MOD, police had assumed responsibility and were liable when the claimant did not receive appropriate supervision and died. Number 2. Where there is a relationship of control between defendant and a third party who causes damage. In Home Office v. Dorset Yard, defendant was liable for the harm when boys escaped a brothel on an island, damaging the claimant's yard. Because the boys were under defendant's control and control imports responsibility. Also, defendant had relationship or proximity to the claimant. Claimant was one of the few parties whose property could forcibly have been damaged by escape. Number 3. Where the defendant creates or permits a source of danger to be created, which is interfered with the third parties. In Smith v. Littlewoods, while there was no general duty on the defendant to prevent third parties causing fire, a duty was found here because the defendant negligently permitted a source of danger to be created and it was reasonably foreseeable to cause damage. Now moving on to liability for third parties. Generally, there is no liability for harm caused by a third party. In Pearl v. Lunenburg of Camden, the Court of Appeal said although the risk of burglary was foreseeable, the defendant had no control over the burglars and was not liable for their actions. There are 3 exceptions to the general rule. It has to be judged in each case whether there is a sufficiently close proximity between the claimant and the defendant. A contact between the parties may create fulfill the requirement of proximity here. In Stanley v. Strowman, the defendant was at the claimant's house to decorate it and promised to lock the front door when he was out. He forgot to do so and the claimant was burgled. It was decided that the contact between them created proximity and the defendant was liable for the actions of the burglar. The decision had to be distinguished from the Hill v. Chief Constable of West Yorkshire, where there was no proximity between the defendant and the claimant's daughter. It has to be seen whether there is proximity between the defendant and the third party. It may create a relationship of proximity if the defendant has to control over the third party and also if it is foreseeable that the claimant will suffer harm. We will revisit the case of Home Office v. Dorset Yard. It was found that it was foreseeable that if the boys escaped, they would steal a yard. The officers responsible for controlling the boys and the Home Office was negligent. If the defendant negligently creates the danger for the defendant, he may be liable if a third party uses that danger to injure the claimant. The Top v. London Country Bus, the Court of Appeal said leaving the minibus did not create a special danger and the defendant was not liable in the act of the third party. As a general rule, there is no liability in negligence for an omission, hence there is no general duty to rescue someone in danger. In Chadwick v. British Railways Board, duty was owed to the claimant who suffered psychiatric harm after he went to help after a train crash in which many people were found liable in negligence. Lastly, if the defendant negligently puts themselves in danger, he will owe duty of care to the rescuer as long as the rescuer is not acting in a foolhardy way.